to you. It's Wednesday. So I really know what happened yesterday. It actually, you know, usually when the announcements don't load, it's really my fault, but this was not my fault. I tried and tried and tried, and it would not let me. I even had another teacher try on her phone, and it didn't let me. So I don't know, like, what happened, but that's okay. We're going to try again. So today, what we're going to do is I am going to have, we don't have a lot of additional announcements today. So I'm sorry, I've got this funky hair thing going on. There we go. So instead of, I'm just going to kind of put all the announcements together. We've got a lot on our announcements today. So Miss Miller has a video to go on along with something that I started doing yesterday. So we're just going to combine them. It'll be fine. So teachers, I'm sorry that it's a little longer today, but it'll be great. It's great. Okay, here's the weather for today. The high of 88, a little better than usual, and it's going to be partly cloudy. It looks like we're not going to have any more rain this week until next week. I'm thankful for the rain, but it has caused a little bit of a problem in the library. We've got some roof leakage, but we'll be thankful for the rain because we really need it. And this year we are going to be doing a program called Character Strong. And it is a program that we're using. You'll do it every Friday in your class. And then you will, we'll also be talking about it on announcements. So this month we're going to be talking about the trait respect. So this month we are talking about R-E-S-P-C-T, about respect. Respect means seeing the good in people and things and treating them with care. Seeing good in others can mean that you look for things you like or appreciate in people, whether they are similar or different from you. Treating others with care means listening quietly when others are speaking and responding with kindness. It can also mean helping out when you see a need or standing up for others. Think about how you can show respect today. Our quote of the week is from the former professional baseball pitcher, Mariano Rivera. I don't wait for people to give me respect. I always give them respect. Today, when talking to teachers, friends, or your family, practice showing respect with your words and actions.
Good morning, Huskies. This is Mrs. Miller, your school counselor. I hope your year is starting off great. Every Friday, our school will talk about different ways for each of us to be good people. For the next few weeks, our focus will be on respect. In addition to learning respect, we will also be learning specific skills on how to show kindness. So let's give a shout out to pre-K and kindergarten this week. They are learning listening skills this month. We can't wait to see your whole body listening. Confucius once said, respect yourself and the others will respect you. I'd love for you to think for just a minute, or maybe talk within your class about it, what it really means that if you show respect to yourself first, that then others will also show you respect. I hope you have a great day, and please make yourself Husky proud. Bye-bye.
Yesterday, Miss Ford did a lesson on the Husky way and how we behave in the hallways. So since I was there for that lesson, I decided that I should go and practice these things with classes in the hallway. So let's see how I did.
Mrs. Wright, you're not supposed to be messing with the teacher's
board. I'm not? Why not?
Because it will rip it.
Okay. Serenity, did you hear Mrs. Wright a minute ago? She was so funny. Wasn't that funny? Hey, Carson. Carson, what are you going to do after school? You know, it's Friday. Do you think that we could do something?
Miss Wright, we're not supposed to be talking in the hall.
What?
We're not supposed to be talking in the hall.
Stop talking.
I'm not supposed to be talking in the hall?
No.
Level zero voice.
a level zero. What am I what am I supposed to do, Carson?
Be quiet.
Be quiet?
Don't say anything.
At all?
You can't talk.
I can't talk.
Keep
that's
the
okay.
Keep
okay.
Down.
So
that's
like this.
The rules
only
over there.
In the hallway.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect.
And it says silent voice in the silent voice level. Did you have a silent voice level?
No.
Were you talking with your friends?
Yes. I just wanted to know what they were doing over the weekend.
So you should wait till you get to your classroom or outside for recess to do that, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
The second one says keep hands, feet, and other objects to yourself. Miss Wright, did you have your hands and feet to yourself?
No.
What did you do?
Well, I was running down the hall, running my hands down because, you know, the hallway's bumpy, those bricks, and it feels really cool when you go vroom, 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 down the hall. And then the bulletin boards, I mean, it's cool because there's like staples and you can like play with it. And I get bored standing at the bathroom.
Okay, so that's right. Look at your hands. You're getting ready to go to lunch. You just have your hands all over the wall in the hallway. Are you ready to go to lunch?
No, that's kind of gross.
That's kind of gross, right? And what if that bulletin board that you messed with was Miss Ford's or Miss Walker's or Miss Wright's? And then you were messing with it and you've made something fall or you tore something? How would you feel?
Really bad.
How would they feel?
Not happy.
Not happy. So where should our hands be when we're in the hallway?
To my side or behind my back?
Back. And then we have one that says walk on the blue line. Were you walking on the blue line?
No.
Okay, you're smiling. What were you doing?
Well, it was kind of fun to like hop off of it and then hop on. And then I was dancing because it's Friday.
So you weren't paying attention to the person in front of you either, were you?
No.
And if
no,
the line
ma'am.
Stopped, could you have hit the person in front of you?
Definitely.
Definitely. And that could have hurt that person, right? Mm-hmm. So we have hallway expectations for a reason. And so Miss Ford needs you to have a silent voice when you're in the hallway. Keep your hands, feet, and other objects to yourself. And walk on the blue line. And you're going to do that because those are our expectations. And you are a husky. I don't want to see you in my office again for any of this because there will be consequences next time, young lady.
Yes, ma'am.
Have a great day.
Thank you, Miss Ford. Well, so I didn't do so great, did I? But you know exactly how to behave in the hallway. So I will be looking forward to seeing great Husky Way behavior in the hall. Please stand for the pledges. And now for the Texas flag. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible. And now for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now the Husky Promise. I promise to respect and value the differences of others, intentionally work towards improvement, demonstrate responsibility for my words and actions, and encourage others often because I have husky pride. Well, that's your news for today. Thanks for tuning in and have a great day, Holiday Heights.